Well, how very interesting. Yeah. Did you hear that? Dingle, dingle, ding, 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 ding. I thought it might be Aguila with didn't have a key or something. I went to the door, nobody's there. Somebody just, who the fuck knows what they were fucking doing? I go, am I talking too loud? For the neighbors? What the fuck? Anyway, interference, bullshit. And I was just starting to talk about multidimensional beings when we got interrupted. So I thought, you know what the fuck? I'll go ahead and finish talking about this subject. Multidimensional beings. So you can a person can be a multidimensional being. I mean, it's just my understanding and definition of multidimensional being is a being that is aware of their beingness or their being in more than one dimensional plane. That's generally what I mean, but everybody is multidimensional, but not everybody is aware of that. So, you know, it's a if you're going to throw that term around, multidimensional being, it'd be good to know whoever's using the term. It'd be good to know what they mean by that term. You might have one meaning for the term, they might have a different one. But there's that. And there's a lot of multidimensional beings here. In other words, beings that is on this planet right now that know they have a life and they have memory of it in other realms and planes and dimensions. And some of them can move there immediately, instantly. And those that can easily move from one dimensional plane to another, the ETs, a lot of the ETs can do this. Some humans can do this. Aguila can do this. These are what I would call truly multidimensional in ability beings. So there's that. I wanted to mention a little thing about the channeling here. I'm a little, this thing about channeling, yeah, they get some very brilliant beings channeling information through human beings. And the human being or the being that is here as the human, they have to kind of either check out or step aside, and the channeler will either speak through the body. Sometimes the channel, the entity will tell the human what to say or do, and then the human will say or do it. That's one way it works. But it's the more common way is that the person steps aside and lets the entity step in and use the voice box and the body while that entity shares their message. And it's called channeling because the person is the channel. Esther Hicks does this with Abraham, and Abraham is not an individual, it's a group, it's a we. Good to know, just take a note there. But Esther steps aside, and the entity, the cluster entity, steps in and says what it says in its brilliance and message. Same with Bashar. Bashar, let's see, it's more of a, it's almost as if Enka, what's his name? Daryl Enka. He goes into a trance state. But does he step aside and let Bashar step in? Or is Bashar another aspect or consciousness of Daryl and they merge and Daryl becomes Bashar, Bashar becomes Daryl? It's all one being in two different realms and just timelines, but they merge and then this other personality that is a part of Daryl speaks through. Doesn't really matter. Bashar, his channel through Daryl Anka. Yeah. So Bashar has a lot to say. And then there's these other well-known channels. Another one is Seth. First read the book Seth Speaks by Jane Roberts, and it's Seth the entity speaking through Jane Roberts. And he's a very strong personality speaking through this person. And you get great messages through doing this. Do you believe them? It's up to you. Are they loaded with truth and some bullshit? You decide. Are they mostly bullshit with a little bit of truth? You decide. Are they loaded with mostly truth and iffy stuff? And is it done on purpose? If there's some bullshit in there, is it done on purpose? What is it? Oh, and another one is just several others. I got their books. I read the books. There's the Pleiadians. Barbara Marciniak, We the Pleiadians. So they channel through her. They speak through her, and they maybe even did automatic writing through her. Another one is Barbara Marciniak, The Arcturians. Yeah. And she's got hundreds of hours of tapes, audio, of the Arcturians speaking through Barbara Marciniak. We get all these great messages. And then there's the Keys of Enoch. It's a book by J.J. Hertog. And J.J. Hertog is the channel, you might say, for the entity or entities who communicate through him to tell that story. And that's a profound and deep and very detailed story about the angelic hierarchies and the history of humanity and beings and the galaxy and life beyond the physical. It's incredibly detailed and deep. And it's like, are you supposed to believe that shit? I mean, that's the idea. Believe this shit. Believe this stuff. But then there's the same sort of thing with the book Urantia. Urantia is another alien word for Earth. Or an ancient Earth word for Earth. Urantia, the Urantia book. And that's channeled. Lots of different beings channeled this information. And then it was taken down. And it's a fat book like this. It's very much like Keys of Enoch in the information, the history of creation and where humanity fits in all of it and where they're going to be in the physical world and the afterlife and all of this, the soul journey and the spiritual journey. And it's detailed, very detailed. Channeled information. It's another channeling. So there's quite a few of these channeled things. And my take, big picture, there are entities and other dimensional planes who have an agenda. Is it good, bad, or neutral? Is it their agenda for them? Is it their agenda for us? Doesn't matter. They got an agenda. They find somebody that they can communicate through, and they share their message with humanity to get people to get on board, believe in, buy into the reality that they're wanting us to buy into and believe. So there's all that. So that's channeling. Okay. There's more here, but I'm gonna go ahead and wrap it up. And this time I'm wrapping it up on my fucking terms instead of somebody ringing the bell. Did you hear that shit? That's fucked up. Ding-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling. And I got up, I went there, nobody there. Nothing. So I don't know if it's what the fuck that was. Anyway. That's about it. Hey, thanks for listening to my long-ass fucking blab. But I just want to do something a little different and share my thoughts about all this. Oh, well, look, here we got the blue avians, the triangle beings, the blue orbs, and the blue spheres. I believe that this is the real deal. I've listened to Corey Good's YouTube stuff, not everything, and I read some of his stuff, and I've read the part about other people are saying things about Corey, or that these beings that are communicating through Corey are not necessarily have our best interests in mind, but they have their own agenda. Who knows? There's so much shit going on. So many lies, so much truth, blah, 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 all mixed in together. So many stories. So what do you believe? Yeah. Mm-hmm. I'm just saying. I enjoy sharing my thoughts and helping you wake up to the possibilities and the potential of what's going on now and what can go on into the future for you, and all that. Okay? All right. And one last shout out to these guys. This is the Great Awakening map, and it is from greatawakeningmap.co. Never heard of them before today, but I appreciate their information here. So check them out. All right. That's all for now. I will talk to you later, okay? Bye-bye.